In last lecture, we have seen how to calculate fault current and how to calculate short circuit KVA. Now, we will see few questions related to that topic. In our first question, they have given the line is connected to a generating station bus bar through a 6000 KVA step-up transformer which has reactance of 6%. The station has two generators rated 10,000 KVA with 10% reactance and 5000 kVA with 5% reactance. Okay, so a line is connected to a station bus bar through a step up transformer with 6000 kVA and 6% reactance. A 33 kV line has a resistance of 4 ohm and reactance of 16 ohm. We need to calculate fault current and short circuit kVA when a fault occur at HV side and at the load side. Okay, so a line is connected to a generating station bus bar through a transformer. Through a step-up transformer, and the rating of step-up transformer they have mentioned, that is 6000 kVA with 6% reactance and is connected to generating station bus bar which has two generator. Okay, sorry for my drawing. Which has two generator, generator A and generator B. The ratings of both the generator they have given, right? So generator A is 10,000 kVA with 10% reactance and 5000 kVA with 5% reactance. The line is of 33 kV and resistance is 4 ohm and reactance is 16 ohm. Okay. Now we need to find fault at this point and at this point. Okay, to solve this numerical, we can use per unit or percentage reactance method, or we use MVA method. Okay, so first we will see per unit or percentage reactance method. See, whenever fault occur at any point, okay, whenever fault occur at any point, then that is the problem for the generating station. Suppose if fault occur at this point, then this is the problem for the generator B, not for the transformers. Okay, if the fault occur at secondary of transformer, then this is the problem for transformer, not for the load. Okay, if the fault occur at the secondary side of the transformer, then this is the problem for this transformer and generating station, but not for the load. Okay, if fault occur at this point, then this is a problem for transmission line, for transformer and generating station, but not for load. Okay, we always analyze fault analysis for the generating station side, okay, not for the load side. So if fault occur at F1, we need to calculate the reactance value of both the generator and transformer. Okay, so per unit or percentage reactance for generator A, percentage reactance for generator A is how to calculate. That is, first we need to select base value, so new MVA base, we select as this 10,000. Okay, anything you can take, but it's better to take the generator rating, that is 10,000 kVA. So X percentage reactance of generator A is 10% into what is the new MVA value we have taken, that is 10,000. What is the old MVA value, that is the rating of generator itself. So this will be 10,000. Okay. So this will give you 10%. Now, what will be the percentage reactance of second generator, that is generator B? So the percentage reactance they have given 5% into what is the old MVA value? Old MVA value they have given 5,000 and new MVA value we have taken 10,000. So new divided by old will give you 10%. Okay. Now, what will be the percentage reactance for transformer? So the percentage reactance they have given, old value they have given 6%. Now we have taken new MVA base value, right? So that is 10,000 new KVA base value. That is 10,000 divided by old KVA base. That is 6,000. So this will also give you 10%. Okay, so if fault occur at this point F1, then this is a problem for generating side, not for the load side. Okay, this is the problem for generating side, not for the load side. So we don't consider this part. Okay, if you need to calculate the fault at F1, so what will be the total reactance value till here? For generator we got 10%, for second generator also we got 10%, and for transformer we got 10%. Okay, and fault occur at the HV side. So the total reactance value, total percentage reactance value till F1 will be equal to 10 into 10. This should be in parallel. So this is 10 into 10 by 10 plus 10, and this is series with transformer impedance. Transformer reactance. So this will give you 15%. So now you got the total reactance value. So what is short circuit KVA? Short circuit KVA is nothing but rated KVA into 100 divided by percentage X. So what is rated KVA we have taken? That is 10,000 into 100 divided by percentage X is 15%. So this will give you 10,000 into 100, I guess 66. Yeah. KVA. Okay. Or we write 66.67 MVA. Now, what about the short circuit current? See, what is short circuit KVA? That is KV value into short circuit current, right? So, what will be the short circuit current? That is short circuit KVA by KV. So, this will be short circuit KVA by KV. So, what is short circuit KVA? That is 66,666.67 divided by KV value, right? So, this is what is the KV value at that point? See, what is the KV value at fault F1? That is 33, because they have mentioned, right, KV value of the transmission line. So, from here, secondary part of the transformer till the load, they have given 33 KV, right? So, at fault F1, what will be the KV value? That is 33. So, this will be 33 KV. Now, this is the phase voltage. We need to convert this into line voltage. So, we need to multiply this with root 3. Now, what you will get? You will get 1166.36 ampere. Okay. Now, we have got the fault current and short circuit KVA at F1. What about F2? At F2. So, till here we got 15% reactance, right? Till here we got 15% reactance. 15% reactance, right? So, after this, what is the value of reactance and resistance? We need to calculate. So, percentage reactance of transmission line is, what is the reactance value they have given? They have given 16, right? 16 divided by KV base square into MVA base, right? So, this will be actual divided by base value. So, this will be MVA base. So, this is KV base square into, we have taken here MVA, I have written here MVA base, this should be KVA base, okay? Now, this should be KVA base. If we write here KVA, what we need to do? We need to divide with this with 1000. Okay. And as I am writing percentage reactance, we need to multiply this with 100. So, this will give you 16 divided by what is KV base square, that is 33 square, into what is KVA base? KVA base for the transmission line, we have taken here 10,000. That will be same for all the equipment. Okay, sorry, no, this will be not square. 10,000 KVA base divided by 1000 into 100. So, this will give you 16 divided by 33 square into 1000. So 16 divided by 33 square into 1000. So this will give you 14.69. Okay. And what about the percentage resistance? Percentage resistance will be, what is the resistance value they have given? They have given 4, right? So 4 divided by what is the KV base of transmission line? That is 33 into KVA base divided by 1000 into 100. So this will be 4 divided by what is KVA base? That is 33 square into KV base is 33 square into KVA base is 10,000 divided by 1000 into 100. So this will give you 3.67, okay, percent. Now, fault F2 occur after the transmission line, right, to the load side. So this is the generating side, that is 10% reactance, and this is the transformer, that is 10% reactance. And what about the transmission line? It has 14.69% reactance value and percent resistance value, and fault occur at this point. Okay, so you need to solve this equivalent impedance. So the equivalent impedance will be, first we calculate reactance value, total reactance, that is till here we got right 15. So 15 plus 14.69, this will give you 29.69%. And what will be the impedance value? That will be equal to 3.67 square R square plus X square, that is 29.69 square. So here you got 29.69 square, okay, and under root of answer. So this will give you 29.91%. Okay. Now, what will be the short circuit KVA? That will be equal to rated value, that is 10,000 into 100 divided by percentage x, right? So instead of percentage x, you can write percentage z also. So this is 29.91, and this will give you 33,426 KVA. Or we can write 33.4 MVA. Okay. And in the same way, we can calculate short circuit current, that is 33.4 divided by root 3 times of 33 KV. Okay. So this should be in KVA, that is 33,426. Because we have taken KV value here. Now, this will give you 584.81 ampere. Okay. So, now the same thing we do with same thing we do with MVA method. MVA method. So in MVA method, we need to calculate the short circuit MVA for all the equipment. Okay. So the short circuit MVA or KVA for the generator A, for generator A will be, that is 10% reactance or generator A, that is 10,000 kVA into 100 by percentage X. So what is percentage X? That is 10%. So this will give you 100 MVA. Okay. And for generator B, what is the KVA value? That is 5000 into 100 divided by percentage X is 5. So this will give you 100 MVA. What is the reactance value? Short circuit KVA value for the transformer. For transformer, this is 6000 into 100 divided by 6%. So this will give you 100 MVA. And what about the transmission line? So for transmission line, you need to calculate, that is KV square divided by Z. So what is KV here? That is 33 square divided by, what is Z here? That is under root of 4 square plus 16 square. So this will give you 33 square, that is 1089 divided by under root of 4 square plus 16 square. So this will give you 16.49. Now 1089 divided by this will give you 66.03 MVA. Okay, 66.03 MVA. Now we will see how to make this single line diagram. See, you have a two generator. One is for 100 MVA and another is of 100 MVA. Okay, these two are connected in parallel with a series in transformer, which is also 100 MVA, and this transformer is connected to transmission line, that is 66.03 MVA, and this is connected to load. Okay, so this voltage here, the voltage level will be different, and here the voltage level will be different. This is 33 kV line. Now fault occurred at the HV side of the transformer, means at this side, and fault occur at the load side. Okay, so this is how we represent single line diagram. Now with the help of this, we will solve short circuit KVA. See, both the generator are connected into parallel. So we need to transform this into single short circuit MVA. So if both the generator is connected into parallel, then this will be simply added. Okay, now transformer is given as 100 MVA and this is 66.03. Now fault occur at this point. Now this 2 MVA, this is MVA of generator 1 and generator 2, and this is MVA of transformer. Now these two are connected in series. So if these two are connected in series, then the total MVA, short circuit MVA for generator and transformer will be equal to 200 into 100 divided by 200 plus 100. So this will give you 66.67 MVA. Okay, now we got the fault short circuit MVA at F1. Now in the same way you can calculate short circuit current. What is short circuit current? That is KVA, that is 66.67 MVA. Short circuit current, that is KVA into 1000 divided by root 3 times of KV, that is 33. So you can calculate like this. Now what about F2 at the load side? This is F1, this is F2. Now we have calculated till here, right? Till transformer. Now this transformer is connected in series with the transmission line MVA. So short circuit MVA at F2 is the combination of all generator, transformer and transmission line. So generator and transformer we got 66 and transmission line is 66.03. So this will be 66.67 into 66.03 divided by 66.67 plus 66.03. So this will give you approximately 33.2 MVA. See, we got the same result. And how easily we got? Okay, you don't need to do all the heavy calculation in this. See, here you got MVA at F1 and here 33.4 MVA at F2, right? So we got approximately same value. Okay. So MVA method can be used in gate where you can solve question quickly. Okay.